inflation, and when most people talk about inflation, they're talking about price inflation, and that's just the general increase in the level of prices for goods and services. And you probably have a sense of that, that every year in kind of a normal economy, things seem to get a little bit more expensive, although not everything does, but especially if you look at something like healthcare or the cost of education, you definitely see things getting more expensive every year. But one interesting question is, how do you measure it? How do you measure inflation? And what the Bureau of Labor Statistics does, and this is actually the most used measure of inflation, they create something called a consumer price index. And the way they do it is that they define a basket of goods, and actually a basket of goods and services. So what they do is they go and they look at the average urban consumer, and they say, what do they need in their life? They might need some housing. They might need some fuel, some natural gas for their home. They need gasoline for their cars. They need energy in other ways. They might need some type of services. They might need transportation. And they try to come up with a basket of all of the things that the average consumer in an urban environment might need. And they figure out how much that would cost them in year one. And let's say that in year one, that it costs them $100. The actual basket that the CPI constructs would not cost $100, but I'm going to do this for the sake of simplicity. And they'll weight these based on what percentage they think people spend on housing versus fuel versus services versus transportation. Then they'll look at the same basket each year after that. So then they'll do the same things, housing, fuel, services, transportation. And then this would be in year two now. In year two, and let's say that same basket costs $102. Well, then they'll say that the general level of price and services for this consumer went up by $2, or went up by, the more important thing is by the percentage, by 2%. So based on this measure, based on this basket of goods, prices went up by 2%. Or you'll hear people on the news say that the inflation rate went up by 2%. Now, I want to clarify, when inflation sometimes talks to inflation in the money supply, so people talk about there's just more money being printed. And often, an increase in the money supply is usually one of the factors that is driving price inflation. But when most people talk about inflation today, they're talking about price inflation. They're talking about the increase in prices. They're not directly talking about the increase in the money supply. Now, this seems like a pretty simple thing to do, but it's not as simple as you might first think, because think about something like TV sets, or especially anything that's technological. Do you look at the same TV set that's getting probably cheaper every year, or do you look at the average TV set that the American household is having? Do you look at the same computer that's getting significantly cheaper every year, or do you look at the average computer every year? Because then you'd actually be looking at a different product. So there's actually a lot of things to think about, a lot of things how you could weight this, and there's been a lot of controversy and when the weightings change in different periods of time. But this is the general idea, and it's really just the best attempt to figure out, on average, how much more expensive or how much purchasing power are we losing from one year to the next.